Residual Gamers.
Hello, dudes, and welcome to the Residual Gaming Podcast. My name is Susurox, and welcome to our very first episode. I'm fucking bored. Anyway, though, as I've already showed you guys before on some of the videos on my main channel on YouTube, I was trying to go and get this new group up called the Residual Gamers, and the Residual Gamers was supposed to be about 6 to 8 people. Unfortunately, things didn't really work out with all of them, but I still have the main dudes, which would be Rob and Bob. Right now, though, we only have Rob with us, but either way, that's okay, so say hello, Bob. What's up?
Hey, how's it going, YouTube? It's your boy Young Rob 90. You know, we ain't doing nothing but just trying to get the podcast established, you know, our first podcast, you know, for the Residual Gamers, whatnot. So, yeah, we're going to probably get more videos out there for you guys and whatnot, and try to figure out what kind of information y'all guys are interested in. We'll probably try to get down to, like, having a breakdown on certain things. Like certain aspects of certain games or a certain, you know, news feeds or whatnot.
News is good. News is very good. We're trying to go and get like more, we're trying to go and get like some type of like community going here. Like, it's not really going to be like great at first, but eventually things will go on and eventually become like full circle and we can go and get more things together in our lives and everything in this gaming stuff. This YouTube stuff is like really difficult at times, especially trying to get something as organized as this to actually work out very well. But we're going to be getting something together. Anyway, though, we're going to go and just be introducing ourselves. I'm not sure where Bob is, but he'll probably like pop up later on, so it's okay. We'll probably just add him in later on. I guess we're just going to start then. What I have to go and do with the Residual Gamers is pretty clear and simple. Just to go and make it very awesome and very useful to helping out more people. The more videos that we can go and possibly make, and the more that we can try our best to go and get you guys the gaming news and everything, as well as just other news for like politics and everything too, I mean, most likely we can go and make you guys a little bit happier. Just do basically whatever we really feel like doing in general without consistently trying to restrict ourselves over something, or for someone, or people. So this is just pretty much as a group of friends just trying to like kick ass on YouTube, working together on Twitch and everything, just trying to make a name for ourselves, as well as helping people in the process. Also, if you guys have any other games or topics that you guys want us to also talk about in the future, or just situations in general you guys want us to go and look into, make sure just to go and let us know inside the comment section below. And we'll definitely go and get up a look, because things like that are really fun and interesting most of the time. A lot of times it's just plain awesome to just try to research, and it is very important so that everybody else always knows exactly like what's happening and such. Anyway, though. Rob, why exactly do you want to go and do the Residual Gamers?
Well, in my opinion, I got to start somewhere in life, you know, pretty much. So I wanted to, you know, pretty much do like, you know, like sort of like a hobby. So pretty much, you know, I like doing, you know, I like helping out people a lot and stuff. So, you know, and whatever I can do to help somebody else out, you know, in the way, at the same time, you know, help myself out as well. But pretty much more so, it's more like a hobby. It's like, you know, as a guy take care of this fish or whatnot, like, you know, stuff like that. But you know, just love, you know, doing the stuff I love to do, and pretty much that's pretty much it for it, in my opinion.
Pretty good. We need some games to talk about though, so I guess I'm going to start with that since this is supposed to be a gaming podcast after all.
Sure.
What did you think about Resident Evil 7, the new one that came out for E3?
Well, my first impressions when I looked at it, it seemed like it's going to be a pretty good game, judging by the look at it. Like you said, Resident Evil 6. I wouldn't say it was the best game, but It seems like it's going to have a better edge over the Resident Evil 6, definitely, in my opinion.
I like the way, like, it went back to, like, its roots, but, like, just did, like, a total nosedive into first-person shooting perspective instead of, like, just, like, the average third-person or, first-eye view perspective, like, normally does. Like, I play, like, the old Resident Evil games as well, but I've never beaten any of them because I got too scared, like, when I was a lot smaller, but, I just had to, like, take the time to actually buy them, like, the best, like, I'm getting more older than I am now, but, I don't know, like, what do you think about, like, the first-person shooting perspective from Resident Evil from, like, the very first time it's ever done this before, really? I mean, like, actually, no, this isn't even the first turn. This is not the first time it's ever...
No, it's not the... you know, we know it's exactly not the first time, because, you know, we got Resident Evil Survivor 1, which I had on PlayStation back in the day when I was a kid, and, yeah, and it's like you said, going back to the roots on that perspective of survival, and I think it's actually pretty decent. I mean, some people don't like first-person shooters. I mean, yeah, but, you know, it's like they're just trying to bring some of that, you know, Resident Evil survival feel back, and that's what I'm looking at when I see it or whatnot.
The shit looks like, whatchamacallit, fucking, it looks like fucking the dubbed-down bootleg-ass version of P.T., though.
Yeah, PT I guess you can say it, if you look at that perspective, yeah. It does kinda... It's kinda crazy, you know? But, like I said, we'll just have to, pretty much wait until they, you know, pull out, you know, the full release of the game to see how it really is. Because, like you said, it's always like that with certain games. Some games, they look like they're going to be bad, and next thing you know, they end up turning out actually alright. Then you got some that look so hype, and then, yeah, they just turn to trash.
How do you think the storyline is going to go and correlate with the new Resident Evil 7 game? Because, like, all the events that happen within Resident Evil 6, do you think, like, all the old characters are going to, like, pop up? Or they're going to, like, play, like, a pivotal role or something inside of the game? Or are they going to wait for, like, Resident Evil 8 or something?
That's actually a good question. Because since I didn't really play too much, you know, of Resident Evil, you know, 6 like that, it will be really hard for me to say, but I'm guessing they might bring back some of the characters, maybe.
I'm still wondering how they're gonna do that.
that's the question, though. It's like, that's the real main question: how are they gonna, you know, get the storyline right and make it pretty accurate and comprehensible, in my opinion. Like, cause you want something that makes sense. You don't want nothing to completely just all out of, you know, proportion, pretty much, if it's not making any sense at all.
I hope that we don't have to fight fucking Wesker in Resident Evil 7 in some way.
Yeah,
that shit's gonna be fucked up in some way.
You know what? Now think about it, I wouldn't be surprised, cause they say, like, no matter, even if you think you killed Wesker, he's always survived.
He is one badass fucking dude. He does not like to die. Every fucking time you think that he's
but
dead.
The whole time, like you said, I already been thought he was, you know, up to no good when I first had the first Resident Evil. Because he just looks so sinister, like the Terminator with the glasses on and
stuff. Only dude with the damn sunglasses on.
Exactly.
The dude that has the best shot, too.
You know it. It's crazy.
The whole curse is inside the game too, though.
Should be nice.
Let's see what's going on. Oh, we'll go to another game. We can go and come back to this later at another time. Next game on the list would be Outlast 2. Have you ever seen the demo of that or played it yet?
Outlast 2. I heard of that game, but I don't think I looked at that game.
Yeah, Outlast 2 is pretty, I've never actually played Outlast yet. I've only been able to go and see videos of it, but as I've seen so far, as well as also what I've heard from other people that have actually played it, it's very scary at first if you've never played it before, but after you've already played it repeatedly, it's not so scary at all. just like a bunch of like shock value or I don't know, jump scares. That's what I was looking for, jump scares. Jump scares, quick thinking, survival, find out different ways to approach things without ever using the weapons I can aim, stuff like that.
Right.
Playing this live at the same time while doing this podcast is kind of funny. I keep always trying to like think of different things as well as also pay attention to this at the same time. So, like, what do you think about just like survival horror games like that now as a whole? Are they like really becoming something new, something more evolved, or are they just becoming more dumbed down and boring?
I don't know, but it seems like since now they. It's almost like, who needs horror games almost when you got Call of Duty Zombies now these days? The way these kids think these days. That's just my opinion right there. Because, you know, it's not really a fact, but it just seems like, you know, more communities are into, like, first-person shooter and zombies. So I guess for them to bring that survival back, you know, survival experience back, I guess, that, you know, going back to some of their roots, which people didn't really look at that survival like that back in the day, which was a totally, you know, whole new experience for Resident Evil back in the day.
I mean, people really do need to like go back to like, their roots and see like how it used to be, because this fucking Call of Duty zombie shit is disgusting. It's
yeah.
Not scary whatsoever. The shit is consistently fucking bullshit. You don't really retain any more skill from it. It's weird.
Nah, you really don't. You're just pressing L1 and what, R1?
Yep. It really just feels like soft horror type shit. I don't know what about that.
Yep. Because if you think about it, like, for let's be for real here. Like, I do a lot of streams for Call of Duty and stuff, and I notice majority of people just like zombies and survival. Mm-hmm. And, like I said, since Resident Evil, 7 coming out, and, like I said, it's got the first-person shooter experience back, and it had already been a survival game to begin with. It seems like, it could, be potential for, like, a lot of little kids to get it.
But how many, people do you think would actually generally just pick up with a horror game like that, the kind of their heart and curiosity about in 2016?
Like, that's a great question.
Most of these people can't even take like a simple jump scare off of Outlast or just like simple indie games and everything. So I don't know. It might work, but it might be work. But it feels like someone would literally have to like ease them into it a little bit.
Something yeah.
Like that, and they might be more likely just to buy like more horror games and just try them out. Mm. That's just me though. I'd be trying to get other people in the horror games and everything. They always have like some stupid excuse of like why they can't do it. It's like the most simplest thing.
I had a bunch of friends like that. They would tell me they're not really into horror games and whatnot. But I mean, they are pretty interesting because, it's like it's always like a puzzle to, playing the game and whatnot. Mm-hmm. And that's one thing I did like about Resident Evil. It was always tedious, but now I don't know how linear it done got, but I remember, like I said, back in the day, the first, like, one through, like, at least one or three, man, them was the hardest and scariest ones. Code Veronica was pretty good, too, as well, but it seemed like it was a lot straightforward. Then, I can't forget Resident Evil Zero. That game was always hard.
I hear Bob in the back.
Yeah, you hear him in the background. He is back. And he should have been in the podcast with us, but, it's fine. We'll probably do another one or not. But
we got time.
But like, as I was saying though, pretty much, it just seemed like a lot of, it seemed like it's going to be a great game, in my opinion. But like I said, yeah, a lot of more kids are going to be prone to it now, because, you know, it's got a first person shooter. They might, if, you know, they get used to the layout or not.
But what made the original Resident Evil game so scary, though? Like, was it just, like, the survival element to it? The camera angles? The zombies themselves? The storyline overall? Like, what made it scary?
I think it would happen to be a combination of how the way they had the story plots and the way they had the camera angle and, you know, scenes and stuff. I think it was very scary back in those days. Like, and then, not to mention it, back in the day, our graphics wasn't that good, but it was pretty rough graphics, so it was, you never knew exactly what the hell the monster looked like at all, even though it was very scary, dude. Like, you look at the dogs, you're like, what kind of dogs are those? But, you know, you do know they dogs, and they about to kill you, and it's very scary. And like some of these other guys, like I said, the new ones, they just don't give me that type of feel anymore.
So, would it be like a sense of urgency, like with the fear factor? Like, hey, if I don't do this, I'm going to die, like, right now, or something like that.
Yeah, that's what the first three gave me, that feel. And it's like, it's not really giving me that feel when I got to, like, it seemed like once I got to 4, it was good, but it seemed like more like a love story.
6 seemed like a love story too. That shit was kind of weak.
Yeah.
Got the love story between Leon and Helena, and it's not really a love story, which is fucking weird. And you have the next love story between fucking, Wesker's son and the blonde girl.
Yes.
You got Chris just being pissed the fuck off the whole damn time.
Yeah, he always does. That's Chris for you, though.
I've never even seen him this pissed off before in my life. I've never seen him in any of the games like that. Just that pissed off for, like, that long.
Nah.
Just funny, man. He just ran out of rages.
But through the series, he has been through a lot of hard times.
That is true. Is he like 40 something? I'm not.
Yeah, I think he's a heavy 40.
I'm not. The blanket is in the closet, like I said.
Which one?
What do you mean which one? It's just one inside the closet. Oh my god, man. Just the blanket. The blanket I normally use. I got another one. Be fine. Anything else? You alright? Good. Sorry, that's my little brother. Anyway,
that's fine.
I guess we can go talk about some more stuff. How do you think Resident Evil 7 is going to try to incorporate multiplayer? Do you even think it's going to have multiplayer at all?
I think they probably will, because like I was saying, most people like the zombies and stuff like that, and I know a lot of people like the Resident Evil 5 multiplayer. I mean, I played it a little bit myself, but like I said, if it does, most likely it's going to have some type of multiplayer, and I'm pretty sure a lot of people are going to try it out.
But how do you think multiplayer or co-op play basically is just going to go on work within a survival horror game that's first person? Will it be like the same? Well, do you think it will be like the same feeling, or do you think it will be like kind of like whatever?
I think it'll be kind of different, in my opinion. I think it'll be some type of, I don't know. It seems like they would make it like some type of Rainbow Six type of shit. I don't know. If it is going to be first-person shooter.
I was hoping I could at least give up the chance to like switch between like third person and first person, but it's just all first person.
Yeah, I was thinking they might do that too, but I don't know if they're gonna do anything like that.
But
judging from my look, it seems like it's gonna be all first person experience, but
I don't think they're gonna do it. Like, make like something so we can go and just see this more, because we don't like really have too much information just like with this one house they have on there where you start out at.
Yeah.
And we get to go and figure things out from the Easter eggs and really sky at the end. Or get knocked out, I guess, but either way, it's still seems pretty good. Anyway though, we got some more topics for PlayStation Network. Also, is Bob still joining us or is he still doing stuff?
I don't know. He's sitting right here right now. I don't know if he's gonna go in his room though.
Alright, that's fine. Alright, so let's go to the next topic for PlayStation News. All we got is Sony PS. I keep fucking tongue tying myself. What do you think about Sony's new PlayStation 4.5 Neo thing versus Xbox One Scorpio, the Xbox One Scorpio shit that was shown at the E3 convention?
Well, I think it's always gonna be competition. They're gonna always throw out like once one step up, I think the other one's gonna try to step up as usual, and it's gonna be. But like far as me knowing like what's inside the system, if I was just going by homework from you know the old generations, like the first Xbox, you know, 360 compared to you know the PlayStation 3, then that'd be you know a big comparison. But you know, I can't really be too accurate on this because you know they got newer hardware and stuff. But I'm thinking that it's gonna have a better upscale to 1080p, because, or I mean 4K, my bad, my mistake on that, because okay. Supposedly they supposed to do the 4K upscale or not, and it's going to be not too much of a difference from how we have on the 1080p upscale.
But what's the difference between 1080 and 4K?
Well, the thing is, anything a little bit above 1080 is 4K, and like I said, it's just tighter pixels and stuff. Makes it look a lot better. But the thing is, it's only up higher by a little bit. Which it will make significantly a lot of difference. Depending on what type of monitors you got. So, at the same time, you still gotta go back to your monitor. Yeah.
That makes more sense with that. Can they go with anything else that's higher than that, or is just 4K like the end goal for like all?
Well, they do have 8K out, but it's not for consumers, and even if it is, hell, who's gonna have the money to afford that? But like I said, if 1080 or 720 is decent enough. But I'm like, okay, if you know you prepare for the future and you just want to have, you know, Ultra HD or whatnot, and yeah, if you got the money to spend, then yeah, I don't see why not. I was hearing about the games. Yeah, you know they have to redo the games or something like that. I'm not sure if that was a rumor or not.
Yeah, I never heard of this before until now. I'm actually liking this.
Yeah, I heard supposedly they since they got the you know full point. You know, the new system or whatever, they have to redo some of the games or whatnot. But I'm not really sure if that's the case. That's just something I heard. That's a rumor. So.
Well, that's alright either way. We'll be able to go and find out later on, probably.
Definitely.
Alright, let's go with the next one. The next topic I guess we could talk about will most likely be the advancement of virtual reality technology. And as you can already plainly have seen before, Yeah, virtual reality is pretty much going all over the goddamn place now. I mean, we got virtual reality with our new consoles and shit for PS4. We got virtual reality at amusement parks, and now we're getting fucking virtual reality within theaters and shit too. So, IMAX Theaters, the CEO of IMAX Theaters apparently is allowing virtual reality to become part of the theater, so you can go and watch the movie in virtual reality now. So, how do you feel about the advancement of virtual technology? Is this good? Is this really, really useful? Or is this just a waste of time? Like, what do you think about the fun of virtual reality?
It's like a trial and error thing. So, yeah, it could be a waste of time. But at the same time, it could be a double-edged sword. So, it's like, you could learn something at the same time. So, it's a learning experience at the end of the day on that. As far as them, you know, trying to figure out the virtual reality or whatnot. But, I'm thinking, like, you know, technology getting more advanced anyway. And I think they already been messing with virtual reality a long time ago. It's just they probably didn't have, you know, they probably just now perfecting it or whatnot.
I think that if we go and keep having this virtual reality stuff going up, then eventually we're going to have something that evolves from that. I'm not even sure, really completely sure what it might be, but I guess I can just do like a fucking guess, I guess. Holograms? I'm thinking like one day we might actually be able to go and just have virtual reality and holograms merged into one single piece of technology where you could actually like psychologically think that you are feeling the hologram as a real physical being or something. That'd be pretty nice, but not like in this day and age yet. If we're just scratching the surface of like perfecting the virtual reality, then we'll eventually move on to something else, most likely. This is pretty good. This is actually getting people and companies and gaming industries, I'm seeing, like, a little bit more active, a little bit more happier to, like, do this type of stuff. I'm still guessing that it might be a lot more expensive than usual, but if people are actually really buying it, the virtual reality devices and everything, and they seem really happy with it, which most people do, then it will most likely change a lot of people's perspectives on gaming and everything, and make them try it out eventually.
Oh yeah, I definitely agree on that.
I just wish like the price is like a little bit fucking lower though. For a virtual reality device for the PlayStation 4, I think it's about $300 or $400 right now. It's still a fucking lot. It's like buying a totally brand new PlayStation. But it's not.
Yeah.
You don't even get games of it, it's just virtual reality visor, so I don't know about the price, but besides the price being too damn high, it should be rather great if they could lower it and give people more of a chance to actually like be happy with it, try it out, have a few games of it. Let's see. What else we got so far? I got a bunch of not good little topics we want to talk about. Do we have everything for PSN news, or do you want to go and move on to Xbox news?
Not sure. Your choice.
Alright. Xbox news is this one. Alright, so, what do you think about Xbox discontinuing the Xbox 360 production? The production of Xbox 360 is just going on for a while, until, like, this year. I remember when the production for PS3 got stopped, so more PS4s are going to start being created and sold, but people didn't really like that too much. But what do you think about that? Was this like a good move, or was this kind of bad?
Well, it seemed like it could be a good move, but then again, it could be a good strategy to force people to buy a new console, but then again, it could, like I said, be bad, because, you know, during these times, a lot of people ain't really got no money to even buy consoles and in order to, you know, find a place to sleep. You know, to lay their heads there or whatnot, so.
Homeless people in the streets.
So it's like, it's pretty hard. And I don't know if, like I said, that'd be a good idea if they was to do it. Considering, you know, a lot of people ain't really fortunate enough to have the money in hand to really, you know, get these, you know, consoles like that continuously, whatnot.
What do you think would be needed to like change things to make it like a little bit better than for the common consumer?
Well, I always think variety is always best to have anyway. Well, in my opinion. So, I see that's what they're trying to do now these days. Like I said, they're bringing out this new PlayStation and whatnot, so you can have it for these 4K TVs or whatever. It's just something, a little more perk to, you know, get people to spend a little bit more money and whatnot.
That makes more sense. If it was like the PlayStation 4 Neo and the Xbox One S, or kind of like those versions or variations, but they talked about like creating two other forms of Xbox and possibly two other forms of PlayStation or something I heard during E3, as well as after it was over. I'm not sure about the PS. Oh fuck, I'm not sure about the PlayStation part, but I didn't know that they did specifically say that for our Xbox.
Oh yeah, definitely. Yeah, I'm sure they're gonna make something, like I said. But like, far as the discontinuation of Xbox, it seemed like it. I don't know. It seemed like it'd probably be a bad idea for them.
Yeah, not too many people were. Because
you know, a lot of people. I don't know. There's a lot of Xbox fans are pretty faithful to that. You know. And they, you know.
There's some people that are loyal as fuck to that shit.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Some diehard Xbox fans that sit there and spend all their money for, you know, Xbox Live and all this stuff, and you know, like you said, they gonna want, you know, they probably want service and stuff, you know, for the Xbox 360. That's just like PlayStation 3 people as well, but you know, they got a little upset, but you know, people gonna have to shrug it off anyway, cause you know, it is getting to the future regardless.
Heaven forbid you have an opinion against the Xbox, you're going to get fucked up by a bunch of damn Xbox fanboys. Holy shit.
Yeah, true. But I mean, I'm just, you know, just speaking it out. Like, I done had both consoles. I'm pretty much like, you know, multiplayer pretty much in general. You know? Because I like all games in general. And I try not to let a fanboy-based thing hinder me for playing a game I like to do, you know what I mean? I like to play, whatnot, excuse me for that, do. But yeah, play. And like I said, I had both of them. Like I had, when I had my PlayStation 3 back in the day, I had, you know, had Modern Warfare 2 for that. And I had Modern Warfare 2 for, you know, Xbox. And like I said, I was enjoying myself. Seeing like, you know, they was both great consoles. Yeah, they both definitely great consoles. I had fun on it. Like I said, the buttons was reversed on, you know, that game, but it was nice. But yeah, but like I said, it should. I don't know. I don't know if it'll be a good idea for them to discontinue. It might be a good idea. It might not be. I really can't say, and the Xbox fans, please don't kill me for saying that, because I'm really not sure, but like I'm saying, I understand, yeah, I like to play for your live and all of that, but like I said, some people just have to move on. I have to move on as well, because, you know, I don't have a console anymore, and I got my computer still. I could probably get, you know, games for it or whatnot, but... But like I was saying, you know, I like to do multiplayer type stuff. So, like I said, it might be a bad idea. It might be a good idea. Who's to say? Until it really happens. But, that's pretty much all I got to say about that one.
To me, Xbox 360 should still be in production. Not just for, like, the, marketing value either, even though like it is kind of small, but just for like the sake of like allowing people to still be able to like afford Xboxes and everything. I know like they lowered the prices for like, the new next gen systems and everything, but it don't really have shit on it. Xbox One doesn't really fucking strike anyone as like really amazing, except for just something like to talk to people on and shit, as I've seen. But you got the PS4 over here, and you can like play as many games as you want on it, the latest shit, and you can still do exactly the same thing you could on the Xbox and even more. So,
true.
I don't know. They should still like have like the Xbox 360. The Xbox 360, even though like the graphics to me are a little bit lower than they naturally are on PS3, it's still something that can go and definitely get people into like gaming in general if they don't like PlayStation for whatever reason, or it's just not for them in general.
Yeah.
Man, let's see.
I agree on that.
GameStop, I'm sorry. Am I looking at GameStop? Xbox is literally just about $100, but they are lowering it to about $80 because no one ever buys it. No one ever buys the shit at all. So it just sits in the damn corner of the store, just collecting dust.
Yeah, that's crazy.
We just need something right now. We need to, like, have some way to, like, allow, more people to go and get the gaming systems that we got to be more affordable, because they're not going to lower the prices anytime soon, but if they did, more people will be able to play, and they still don't get the amount of money that they normally would, if not double to, because it's more people. More likely, like, more casuals and shit, but they'll still be, like, doubled to an extent that place, Sony's still getting more money just off of the fact that more people are actually buying the system, and maybe even Microsoft will get more money, too, with the same thing if they lowered the price a little bit more for Xbox as well. But that's just me on that. Anyway, though.
Yeah.
Yeah, we can go on to the next topic if we still have, like, want to talk about on this.
Alrighty, we can go to the next one.
Alright, next topic is Call of Duty Black Ops 1 now being available for compatibility, backwards compatibility for Xbox 360. How do you feel about that? Like, should they have done this a long ass time ago for Xbox One and made it backwards compatible? Backwards compatible from the start, or should they? Is this like okay and it's just like whatever to you?
Well, then again, like you said, it probably should have been did it because, it goes back to what you were saying about the them, you know, getting the place, you know, getting the Xbox 360 for affordable price or whatnot, and stuff like that, and since, you know, yeah, it seemed like it could be a bad idea because somebody could say, well, I can just get a 360 and just, you know, play that like that, but. I mean, well, look at people on Tekken. You got a lot of people playing tag on, you know, Xbox One now, and it's like, you know, maybe because, you know, they couldn't buy the other console, or they just happen to like the Xbox One. And, yeah, you probably have to have something like that out there for certain people. So, yeah, it might be good for them to bring it back for the Xbox One, for them to play that.
Speaking about that, how do you feel about that, Tekken being on Xbox One? Was that like a real big surprise for you, or was that like uncalled for?
It was a bit of a surprise for me. I actually thought, you know, see, I always been thought Tekken was always PS3, well, not PS3, but PS exclusive in general, back in the day when it first started out. And I see they're trying to branch off to a little bit more multi-platform thing now. And, yeah, the tats has changed and stuff, so it's like, yeah, I can see it's going to be multi-plat. And, like I said, I'm a multi-plat guy sometimes, but seeing like it should be only a PlayStation exclusive only type of thing anyway. But, I mean, who am I to say that, like I'm saying? Cause I play multiplayer in general anyway, so. But I always gonna say, at the end of the day, it's still gonna be same more like a PlayStation exclusive, because if you look at like the viewers and all that stuff from Twitch or whatever, and you got these Xbox One streamers and stuff, and yeah, they do get some viewers, they do get a viewers, but it's like. Since I'm on PlayStation 3, you know, a couple of people know me in the tech community or whatever, and like, you're when I stream, it seems like I end up taking over their streams when I'm streaming. Like, well, it makes it even harder for the Xbox streamers, since, it's, you know, since tech has seemed like it should always been a PlayStation exclusive. And that's why a lot of people watch the PlayStation But it's more, not saying none of the Xbox players aren't skilled or anything like that. But it's just the simple fact of what I was saying right there.
I get what you're saying with this. Like, whenever I go on to Twitch, too, I mostly don't even see any PlayStation people anymore, except for just the Xbox people. It's just completely oversaturated now with just Xbox streams. You know, they're not too good. It's a lot more of them taking the game seriously because they never had it before, really, like that, than it is PlayStation players who have had it for years and everything. So I can definitely understand that, but I don't know.
But the thing is, when they stream, though, it's like majority of them just stringing Ghost Battle, and I'm like, okay. It's already hard enough. For you to, you know, to get anybody to look at Tekken. It's already kind of hard to do that. And then, like I said, it's on Xbox, and not like I said, I'm not being no fanboy or anything like that, but. Like I said, most of the majority of people think it should have always been a PlayStation exclusive, so majority of people are going to look at the PlayStation players a lot more.
The PlayStation players know what they're doing. Xbox.
Yeah, that's true.
They still got to learn. They got to go through that struggle like how we all had to do when we first got that shit.
Yeah, definitely. It seems like, I'm just going to be frank. It's like, the Xbox, they gotta kill me for this. Majority of the Xbox players that I done played, they play more like Tekken Revolution players.
Oh, they ain't sure.
Like some of them. I ain't gonna say all of them, because I don't, like I said, I ain't being no fanboy, but majority, like the one, like, I done fought some good ones, like some of my friends on Twitch would not. And they, you know, they got both consoles, or whatever, and they play pretty decent. But I'm saying, like, the majority of them, they playing Ghost Battle and stuff like that, because they're pure casual. And I'm not really trying to say trash or anything, but I would hate to see what Tekken Revolution would have been like on Xbox.
Wait, I thought they already had Tekken Tag Tournament 2 from Xbox, but not Tekken Revolution, though.
Nah, oh my God, I mean, Tekken Revolution.
Xbox, I would lose my shit. I would definitely.
See, that's what I'm saying. Like, I would hate to see what a player would play like if they had Revolution on Xbox. That's all I gotta say about that one.
Jeez, man. Oh, God, I'm gonna be fucked up. I really hope they don't have to do that. I really hope.
I don't think they would, but I'm just saying, just imagine that, though.
There will be so many scrubs walking around here thinking that they're the shit.
It's gonna be like Soul Calibur 5 all over again, dude. Like
popularity contest.
Like all the scrubs thinking they're so good and they suck so bad, but the mechanics are so bad that they let them type of people get away with what they do. And I'm like, that's so retarded.
We'll probably be able to go and see some more in the future. You know, like Tekken 7 and shit coming out soon, so we'll probably make like a little spin-off series for that as well later on, if it goes well.
Definitely.
I swear, if it's Tekken Revolution 2, I'm done.
Tekken Revolution 2? Wow.
I can't do it. Like, can you get any faster with that?
Wow, I mean,
it's already
like, really?
Fast-paced as fuck, but no, I don't think you can get any faster than just regular Tekken Revolution. If you can, then fuck me.
The frames are the same, kind of non-existent in that game, because it's like, I know the game is like 60 frames for like, you know, for the regular, Tekken Tag or whatever, but it seems like the frames really doesn't really count on that game, because you got the red moves and all that shit, and it seems like the moves are a lot faster on there anyway.
I actually got a little nervous when Tekken Revolution came the fuck out, because I honestly thought they might want to have like a mode for Tekken 7 that will allow you to go and do like those special moves and everything and be invincible like while you're doing it. I mean, like, they have like a version of it, I guess, but it's like a slow motion hit, so if you do like the same power attack at the same time, then it'll like do like whatever's like the fastest at the last second to like a little slow motion effect.
Alright. It's got that Street Fighter 4 like effect for when you do an ultra and who's ever's hit to get the crush or not like that.
That's actually okay. Just no fucking.
That ain't too bad. I don't think that's too bad.
We'll have to go on and see like whenever we can go and get that game though.
Definitely.
Anyway though, let's talk about a different topic. Next up for the Xbox, we just fucking branched off the PlayStation first for the last one, but yeah, next up for Xbox, let's talk about the two new variations of Xbox One that was announced at E3. Microsoft apparently was talking about how, in addition to just having the Xbox One Scorpio, that they also have a new, smaller variation of the Xbox One, as well as a bigger version of the Xbox One as well. I don't even know how the fuck this is gonna work, but apparently they're gonna name different things. Still Xbox in the name, but just different things. They have not given a specific name for it yet, but what do you think about it so far? When I first thought about this, I was like, what the fuck? Because I don't know how the fuck this is gonna work, and I really don't know what type of compatibility things they're gonna have for it, or if it's gonna be compatible or backwards compatible with like past games or anything like that at all.
Yeah, that's a good question.
They say that it's going to be better than Xbox One and Xbox One Scorpio, but I don't know how, though. Like, how can you make it better than those two systems so far?
Well, they're going to have to do a lot of work on that. And I think the system is going to be a lot bulkier if they're really going to do something of that magnitude, then they're definitely going to have to resize the system to make it even bigger. If they're gonna actually, because my thing is, the engines and stuff for the for the reverse compatibility. That's my thing right there. And it seemed like it would be complicated. Like, cause look at the PlayStation 3 trying to be reverse compatible for the Dream engine for the PS2. The 80 gig was, I ain't gonna say it was a failure or anything, but yeah, it's pretty much, power. Not too great. It's good, but it's like it gets hot too quick, shit like that, and they're gonna really have to take their homework on shit like that.
They still have it play like the same way, like without messing up too badly and everything.
Exactly, because it's like that GPU does get hot.
Then we gotta find out a different way for this. Like, I know they got the money to do it, but I don't know. Just like the knowledge to do it, I don't know like how they can possibly mess this up too badly.
But it sounds like they're gonna have to add more size to it if they're really gonna do backwards compatibility. Because it seems like it's gonna have to have more hardware in it for it to do it. Because it's like the best, like, for example, the PlayStation 3, the best consoles for reverse compatibility was the 20 gig and 60 gig. The 80 gig was like, it only had partial software emulation. So, some of the games, they're going to be a lot buggier than others. But, like, the other ones had actual PS2 hardware in them. So, I'm thinking they're gonna have to put some of the old hardware in it too, as well.
That makes sense. Old software with old hardware with new software could actually be beneficial if it works and it doesn't like mess up anything, possibly. Also, what about the smaller one? If they make like the smaller version of the Xbox One, what exactly would that like imply? Would it have like more data, or, like less processing speed, or more processing speed, less hard drive space? Like, what would happen with that?
That's a good question, because they're making a smaller one. It seems like, I don't know. It seems like they're just trying to get more sleeker designs, in my opinion. But then again, the design might be for a reason though. And like I said, it could be just one of those things, like how the PS3 Ultra Slim thing is. Just probably just a design, whatnot.
I think it's gonna have like more compacted stuff in it somehow. It's gonna have something.
Yeah, I'm thinking it's gonna have too. Yeah, definitely. I think it's gonna definitely have more like more compact modules and stuff in it.
It's gonna have one thing fucked up that I really think we're all gonna notice at the last minute, but it won't really be like much of an issue until we actually figure it out. That's what I'm thinking, like the smaller one. And the bigger one is gonna be like something very important missing from it. Because they have like a tendency of like fucking things up like that. Like the games will work, but just like little things that can make it like really just perfect, it's not in it most of the time.
Yeah.
Also, how do you feel about Xbox not having like backwards compatibility for like a while until like recently? Do you think that really takes away from like the value, the real marketing value of the console itself, and most likely one of the main reasons why people would not buy it too much over the PlayStation 4?
Yeah, it seemed like that. If you was outside looking in from that perspective, yeah, it seemed like that would be the case. But at the same time, I wouldn't really fully know. But for the most part, like I was saying, it seemed like it could be that way. Because since it ain't that big a guy is compatible yet.
So I'm wondering about that though. Why the fuck did they not allow the PS4 and Xbox One to go and be backwards compatible, or at least have like a different variation to it after like a few months after the original console was out? That would have gotten each of the companies so much more revenue and everything too, because there's nothing better than being able to go and play like your old games and shit from the old days instead of just allowing them to like catch dust or try and trade them into fucking GameStop and not getting anything for it, really.
Yeah, that's true. It seemed like they would've, but I guess and thinking about the ergonomic designs and how the way the thing gonna work and process, because maybe like you said, it might be too complicated for them to get the right hardware components for it, to emulate old games or whatnot in the engines.
Wait, so when you're using a backwards compatible PlayStation 3, does that like overheat the system a lot more than usual to where it can actually be damaged permanently?
Yeah, it can get white lights, which is, yellow light of death. And like I said, the way they made it, I think they kind of rushed it when they made the first compatibility on the 80 gig. But after a while, they did their little homework, and the 60 gig and the 20 gig is definitely better than the 80. So, the only thing about the 20 gig is it doesn't have Wi-Fi on it, and the 60 is the best because it has the Wi-Fi and it has, Ethernet cable. And the 80, it's got some Wi-Fi antenna, but it's not as great as, the 60, and on top of that, the reverse compatibility isn't that great because of the partial software emulation.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
fuck me. I'm sorry, but we got like some more topics to talk about with this a little bit more. About Xbox. Wait a minute. Actually, well, that's pretty much it. We gotta go and get on to fucking politics and shit. Not with this podcast. That's pretty much all that we got for right now. I'm sorry.
Oh, you good?
Is there anything else you want to add, or like any other stories that you heard about that you want to like discuss real quick? Because we don't really have any other stuff. I'm pretty much out of topics.
Well.
Oh wait, I got one more. Fuck me. I'm sorry.
Okay.
We got the Overwatch thing. Remember how Overwatch just kind of like randomly popped the fuck up on Twitch and everything? Yes, I want to do premier tournaments. They have like a new ranked play system and everything enabled for that. How do you feel about Overwatch being a competitive game, even though it's like on a casual type of format?
Well, I think it's always more power to the player, you know? It's like, yeah, they should probably have something like that for them guys that's really think, you know, they could actually be competitive at that game, which it does seem like it's got some competitive properties in that game. Although it's mainly more of a team-based type of thing, I think. And I guess it'll be good for them to do something like that, because, you know, it brings more people towards the game, and, you know, a lot of people like rank these days, so, yeah.
I kind of like it, but then I kind of don't like it at the same time. Gameplay is like pretty good. Any shooting game or just competitive multiplayer game in general should have it. But again, I don't really personally see Overwatch like as like a truly competitive format style game, though. It looks like it could be it, but it just doesn't feel like it, or even like really look like it. You don't get like that same sense of urgency that you need to win this match like how you would like in most other competitive shooting games.
It seemed like when I first got the beta on the PC, and it seemed like I'm a first person shooter, you know, hardcore type of guy back in the day, and I have, you know, still have my FPS freaks and whatnot, and I was lighting people up when I first got on that game on PC. It was ridiculous, dude. It's like shooting them up with ease, and I'm like, bro, it just depends on what type of hardware and. Like, if you got a game and mouse and keyboard, you probably have an edge over a lot of people and stuff. And it's like, yeah, it could probably be competitive. It just depends. But it's one of those Call of Duty Ghost-like things, I think. Yeah, it gives me that type of feel. Like, not saying the game is bad, like Call of Duty Ghost or anything, but I'm saying, like, you know, certain things like attributes and stuff like that. It's like, okay, tracers, guns, they've got some decent damage if you know how to use a teleport and stuff. But her health is not too great, but yeah.
I cannot use that bitch whatsoever. I tried.
I used her before. I tried her. She's pretty nice. If you, like I said, if you have control freaks and you were shooting with her, yeah, she is pretty nice. Cause I have to keep the bullet always lined up on them. Cause you know I'm like one of those type of guys. Just gotta make sure I get every bullet on. Yeah.
I cannot use her though, dude. I tried for hours to master her. I kept shooting. I kept teleporting. I cannot use her. My person on there is the Ice Girl May. I think that's what her name is.
Yeah, May's pretty nice. She got that little freeze and stuff. I played with her before. She got a little nice little shield property and stuff like that.
She's pretty cool. She heals herself. She's fucking icicles at people's faces. And she's fucking adorable. I don't know. And she can heal herself. That's like the main thing. She can heal herself. Most others cannot do that. Like in the middle of fights.
True.
Seriously though, if we play Overwatch again though, I'm gonna like definitely go and get your health card, because I can't fucking use her.
Oh yeah, definitely. If I get the game again, but the question is, I'm just not sure which platform I'm gonna get if I'm gonna get the Overwatch. But I'm thinking it's gonna be PlayStation 4 though.
If it's PlayStation 4 or even Xbox One, we'll finally like do it. I don't have an Xbox One yet, but I'll probably go and end up getting one just to, like, try it out. I want to go and try to do some more reviews and everything on the game soon for the first time. Later on.
Oh yeah, definitely. Definitely have to get the other console as well. So I don't want to just not have the console and then, you know, talk about it a lot. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Gotta try out everything in this bitch. Anyway.
Oh yes, sir.
We don't have more topics left. Do you have like any news or anything?
Well, not at this moment.
Damn, could have got anything wrong. What the fuck?
Yeah, it's going on at my house too. Firecrackers are real.
God damn. Yeah, that's. Oh, fuck. We don't really have any. We don't have any topics left, really, but fuck it. I guess we can go into Zunder's ear then. If you guys enjoyed the podcast, or if you guys find this slightly interesting, this is just like a first go. We're going to be having more stuff up. We'll probably just be going a lot faster with this when we want to start getting more topics and become a little bit more comfortable doing it. And yeah, things are going to be a lot better very soon. And also, hopefully, it just won't be like the two of us. We can actually have like a full team and everything later on. It is kind of late though, so you know, I don't really expect too many people to be on at the moment. So that's okay too. So it's alright. Anyway, though, we're just gonna go on in here, Sibs. It's fucking fireworks outside. It's not like a fucking gunfight, but you know what? Just a bunch of fucking fireworks in the back of my house and in front of my house at the same damn time. Not fucking fun. And I'm gonna have to go. So, yeah, if you guys enjoyed the podcast, make sure to go and check out the video version on youtube.com/Susurrux, as well as also check out Rob's channel as well at young_Rob90. Just check out his channel on youtube.com, as well as also his Twitch channel as well. A link to both of our channels, as well as Bob's, will be inside the description box below so that you guys can check them out for yourselves. Or if you guys just feel like chilling out with us for the live streams, we occasionally do them throughout the week. It's not always a podcast, but we just basically just chill out. We just play games, chill out, make fun of people occasionally, and just kick ass as we usually do. Find out some new information to like, go and give to you guys eventually. So everything's pretty good. Do you have any closing statements, Rob?
Well, guys, like I said, this is our first, you know, podcast and whatnot, and pretty much, you know, we're just trying to, like I said, bring up a little foundation and trying to get something going, because, you know, we've been waiting and debating about it, but, you know, we just got to get stuff going. You know, my birthday came, you know, not too long ago, maybe a day ago, and you know, I just want to get things going.
Happy birthday, Rob, again. I believe your birthday, my nigga.
Appreciate it.
That was another thing. For all you fuckers that did not come to the damn birthday stream, fuck you guys. I spent over 3 hours on Twitter trying to go and get people to come to this bitch, and nobody decided to really show the fuck up except for a couple people. Those of you guys who did, you guys are fucking awesome. I got something special for you guys coming up soon. I fucking 40 dudes that said they were gonna fucking pop the fuck up, and they never did. Except for just like 3 on my part. You pissed me off. I'm sorry about that, though, Rob.
Nah, that's fine. See, it was a good day, though. I had a nice little birthday stream going. Had at least like a, I don't know, maybe 30 people. Nah, almost 30. It was like 20, maybe 23 people there.
We need to get more people next time. We'll have to like plan something special for you next time with streams and shit.
Yeah, we'll do something. Maybe next time, if money gets right, if I could do raffles or something like that.
Raffles, contests, something. Just some funny shit.
Something.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Either way, though, we don't really have anything else to talk about right now, but we will soon. We got like a bunch of other topics for like another day. Got some boots and shit. I have to go through a little bit more, but anyway, though, Happy 4th of July, everyone, and we're gonna see you guys fuck later. So, yeah. Bye-bye from the residual.
Peace. Place.